Yes, hello everyone. It's Peter Leko. It's my second Banter Blitz on Chess 24, and now in a very special occasion, the Legends of Chess. Most probably you have witnessed all the dramas that happened to me today and also in the previous days. I mean, today's match against the legendary Vishy Anand was incredibly intense. I believe that the match probably didn't deserve any winner because it should have been a draw, but the whole format is so brutal. There are no drawish results. I mean, the match cannot end in draw. And finally, after coming back after 2-2, winning the fourth game, I managed to win against Vishy Anand the Armageddon game with the white pieces. So of course I'm very, very happy, but at the same time also feel very sorry for Vishy. I mean, it was a great match. I mean, these first two games were incredibly tense. So, yeah, that's my story of today. But we are not here to discuss that. But I just wanted to say how happy I am, of course, and relieved to get these 2 points today. Because, yeah, the previous days, I had some very unlucky matches against Magnus Carlsen, where I had very good chances against Vladimir Kramnik as well. Yesterday, all dramatic matches. It's a big, big pleasure. It's just fantastic to play this event. But let me take the first challenge, and here we go. Let's see the first game. Yes. It's Liv Tyler. Wow. Is it really Liv Tyler? I don't think so, but okay, let's see. Let's see. The game is on. E4, C5. No Italian. I played so many Italians today with Vishy. I feel like it's enough. It's time to change. And this is, what is it? 3-0. Yeah. So it's a kind of semi-Armageddon. No increment. So then I have to play as quickly as against Vishy, because that was actually the strategy, and it worked perfectly, that I was playing very, very fast right from the start, and I managed also to put Vishy under some pressure, which was very important, because if in Armageddon, I think if Black gets some easy, comfortable position and can play very quickly right from the start, then it's very tough to be wide, because then you feel the pressure. But luckily, I somehow got a good opening, and it was unpleasant for Vishy. He had to think, he was burning time, and this time factor finally proved decisive. And now I'm allowed the position action sacrifice. How can I resist this? I mean, in the Sicilian, that's the whole point, going rook c8 and giving the exchange. So as I said, this is my second Banter Blitz, because I'm not sure that everyone knows it. I had a lot of fun in the first one, but I think those who watched it or who have witnessed it can actually be very happy, because they saw me play online blitz, online chess, after like more than 10 years of absence. So it was my very, very first games, and the games were shaky. I mean, I remember I even didn't have a proper mouse. My mouse was shaky, everything. Now for the tournament, I got a good chair, I got a good mouse. I mean, it's a whole different world now. I mean, probably you guys will be able to flag me, but I'm not sure that it's gonna be so easy as last time. I'm more confident. I remember, I got so many nice feedbacks. So thank you very much, everyone. When you get nice feedback, it basically encourages to do more. There was already also big talk about when will be the second Banter Blitz, but somehow I have been also so busy. And then later it was clear that this tournament is coming. I also wanted to little bit do some preparation myself. At the same time, my student Vincent Kaimel is playing in Biel. We also had to prepare for that event. So many, many things to take care. Oops, this is not check, but okay. This was already lost position anyway. Thank you. And let's take so many challenges. I mean, really sorry, guys, that I will not be able to take all of them, of course, but I mean, I will try to take as many as possible. I'm still a little bit new. That's why I take some time. Okay, so here we go with a new game. GF Conesa. Let's see. C4, C5. This we have practiced with Kramnik yesterday and also with Magnus. Let's see if that practice helps. No, this is already a different position. This is now slightly different, but very topical. It's like a big main line. Okay, I'm gonna go D5. I will be aggressive. Yeah, my opponent knows his stuff. Bishop D2, very calm. Just like Kramnik. Look at this. I mean, the same idea. Of course, white is playing for B4. That's clear. That's obvious. But yeah, now let me break. I got a chance to break in the center. Let me try to take good use of it. And this is also 3-0. Yeah, so okay. Oh, now let's destroy the pawn structure. Always like to disturb the opponent's pawn structure. Having some comfortable position. Just some comfortable position. Bringing the pieces and playing quickly. This is actually one of the most important thing. Only while you are talking, it's not so easy to play that fast. That's actually the trick I noticed with my previous banter, that especially when I played for the first time and without an increment, it was like, oops, I mean, I'm talking and I don't even see the pieces. So it was quite a challenge. But now I control the clock, nice, and also control the position. This is how it should be. Queen c4, clever move. Okay, let's go bishop d5. Okay, takes, because I'm checking the bishop. Queen c6, check, oops. And it's not just the bishop, actually, also the white king is in some dire straits. This is now very, very much checkmate-ish. Oops, checkmate, yeah. All right, so let's see, let's take the next challenges. Suddenly I scrolled way too fast. Okay, let's see. Now let's see who is next. Sankukai. Let's see this battle. I already got this challenge last time, then somehow I missed it. But now we are having this battle with Mr. Sankukai. Let's see, it's Amoroso Limo. The only question, what are we playing? Do we have seconds or not? I never know where it's written the time. But yeah, probably we are getting some seconds. Yeah. Okay. So strategical battle. I got the two bishops. My opponent got a very, very solid structure. Typical line for blitz from the black side as well, because black can play very, very fast. I mean, the natural moves. I will try to rely on my two bishops because black wants to go some b5 also. and I want to break it with d3 d4. I mean, that's the strategical battle here. Who will manage to get its plan first? So black got to b4. The question is now, what does it really give? Now I'm breaking with d4. Now my light squared bishop comes to life. I mean, that's something to look forward to. I see some b5 square. If my bishop can land on b5, that would be quite awesome. That would be quite awesome. Okay, so I mentioned it. Let's keep my word, bishop b5 played. And now the question, okay, let's go a4. I weaken the b4 square. It's kind of double-edged. I don't like to give any square for my opponent, but okay. I mean, something for something. Just something for something. So, very, very strategical. But I feel like I'm having things under control. But okay, I'm not sure about this bishop g5, bishop h4. It's a very ambitious way to play it because I'm hitting the e7 pawn, but the bishop on e3 was so nice. I mean, I was not that pleased to move it. Knight f6. Okay, but now I would like to break with e5, but whom will it benefit? Whom will it benefit? This e5 business. Rook d8, intermediate move. I wanted to sacrifice the queen with EF6 because I have some, but it's not working. Unfortunately, it's not working. So I should not play for the galleries. Should not play for the galleries. Yeah, knight d5. So okay, let's play queen e4. Stabilizer. Black is so solid. Kind of irritates me because one has the thing, I have bishop on b5, I got the pawn to e5, black's position should collapse, but hang on, can I sacrifice the piece? Takes, and then queen h7, well, looking very good, but I don't see the mate yet there. Okay, then let's stick to good old-fashioned blitz style, just break the position, not to sacrifice anything. I think Magnus wrote some or made some lesson that he was saying attacking without sacrificing. Yeah, that's of course the dream scenario. That's how you would like to have it. And Magnus manages quite a lot of times just to get a winning attack without sacrificing anything. And now I'm doing the same. I feel like I'm doing the same because I'm breaking on the king side. I have attack. Yeah, black sacrificed the pawn. This was actually correct. Very correct decision. Feel like my opponent is actually a very, very nice player. I don't understand the rating. I mean, why does he have 22-26? I mean, it looks like a really high class, strategically high class player. It's very, very tricky. Okay, let's go g4. Vamos. Okay, g4, winning some tempo, okay, taking on g5, so settling queen h7, now let's take on e6, let's collect. I mean, that's when you already get everything ready, then the tactic comes to you. Okay, let's play conservative. I mean, endgame and two pawn should be should be good enough. But all of a sudden, I have to be careful a bit. Because one would like to win this already a tempo without any efforts, but strangely enough, there are some strange things happening. Okay, check. This check is nice. I would like to play f5. I already wanted to play f5 before. And I mean, this it screams, it's begs to be played. Okay, now I have six. Vamos. I mean, why to hesitate? Let's go. Let's go. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Thank you, Sankukai. It was a great game. It was actually strategically quite instructive. I mean, get the two bishops, and if you get two bishops, then just go. Okay, some fellow Hungarian colleague, let me play Balázs Arató. It's already my move, yeah? Let's play with some Hungarians. I mean, they are also rooting for me so much during this this Legend of Chess tournament. I mean, also everyone, thank you very much for all the congratulations, all the best wishes. I mean, for today's congratulations, but also, I mean, I had so many ups and downs, and everybody was still kind of bombing me with messages that, okay, keep on going, do it, you can do it, you might do it. I mean, the most difficult part when you are somehow losing matches, which you feel like you had all the chances and all the rights to win them, actually, on one side, you are kind of happy that, okay, I played a great match. On the other hand, those losses finally hurt much more because you feel like you deserve more. And let me just say a few words about the format. I mean, I feel that this format is very, very tricky with 3 points, yeah? Because, I lost all those matches in very tense fights, 2.5, 1.5, and I got 0 points. My opponents got 3, and it basically doesn't really matter what kind of fight you have been put in. If you lost the match, you just get 0. It's very brutal. It's for my taste, it's too brutal. Luckily, I won 2 Armageddon, so I have finally now 4 points. But yeah. Those 3 matches, they hurted me big time. They hurted me really big time. So, okay, now I'm cashing in. While I was talking, I was trying to mislead my opponent, thinking that I'm not focused on the game. No, I was focused. I mean, one has to be focused all the time. I know last time I had a very tough time. People were flagging me. Somebody escaped by miracle to a draw. I still remember this position with the bishop and wrong color. What a save by, I don't remember suddenly the name, but I think it was a British player. that was even some F3 Nimco theoretical clash. I was not ready psychologically in Banter Blitz to have theoretical debates. Yeah, okay, now this is looking very good. This is just rook up. Basically, I feel like my task is to try to win it as quickly as possible so that new players will get a chance. Okay, my opponent is fighting, but okay. I will let him fork me, but I'm also taking everything. And I have 2 minutes. This will be more than enough for me to convert. Yeah, thank you. So Balázs from Hungary, we had a big match, but it was some Karokan with the pawn on h5. I wonder if maybe it was a mouse slip because the pawn belongs to h6. Exactly this g5 g5 square proved to be okay. Jomi Bema. Let's see another Sicilian. Oops, see Sicilian, the Alapin. This has a very solid reputation. Let's see if this reputation will be intact. I mean, it's very tricky. It's, and this whole line, what is our time control now? I even don't know our time control. Is it 3+2 or is it? Is it three? Ah, yeah, it's 3+2. Okay. Yeah, just to know, because this Armageddon's already are hitting me on the head. I don't know when I can think, when I have to play instantly. I mean, usually in my childhood, we played a lot of games without increment. Yeah, those were my blitz skills. So for me, to be honest, playing without increment is very natural over the board. But online, because I'm not into this pre-move business, but now I'm also trying. I'm trying because I understand that playing without increment and not using pre-move in certain situations, it's just a very big disadvantage. So good or bad? Okay, what does it happen? What do we have here? Okay, queen f4. Let's isolate the pawn of my opponent. At the start. Yeah, let's play for the books. And let's change this bishop. And let's play good knight versus bad bishop. Just illustrating what the old maestros were teaching us. Let's see what this game will show. Yeah, now I'm controlling the clock. Things are looking good. I mean, how to create counterplay for black? Yeah, this is the question. On the other hand, sometimes when you have a good knight, it makes you lazy because you feel like that thanks to the good knight, it's just elementary technical task. And here we go. My opponent is ready to sacrifice the pawn for some play. That's exactly what I was saying. So, okay, now I will sacrifice the pawn back and play a completely different strategy now. If you already discuss certain strategies, let's see what my queen and knight will be able to do against the king. Because yeah, white got rid of the isolated pawn, but still my queen and knight seems to be very, very dominant. I would like to find the force win already, but no, there is no force win. So okay, let's improve the position. Yeah, can you see five? Clever move. Actually, where is my mating threat? Where is my mating idea at all? Maybe I was too careless, yeah? That's exactly what I was saying, yeah? That sometimes you just enjoy too much. You have a good night, but I still have a good night. That did not change. Oops, there's a fork. That's a fork, so the knight was just too irritating. Finally, my opponent cracked, so that's just a technical job already. No, this pawn on e7 I still need. It locks out the white bishop and black resigned. Thank you very much. So let's take new challenges. Let's take new challenges. Okay, I see some Kramnik student. Let's see. I mean, is it really Kramnik student? Let's see how nicely will he play chess, because Kramnik is just an incredible master. I mean, master of all the finesses. I mean, feels also dynamics extremely well. The playing the match with him yesterday was just so much pleasure. I mean, despite the result, of course, I was very, very angry and upset about the final outcome, but the match was just fantastic. I mean, so far in this tournament, it seems like if there would not be fourth round, I mean, fourth game of the day, then things would be very nice for me in the tournament, because up till today, I had lost all my last games, all my fourth game, and even in a terrible manner. That's actually what hurts, because, okay, to lose, it's not nice, but when you feel like those losses were basically just presented to the opponent, that's what really hurts. And I believe that it's connected that I don't have enough practice, and somehow here's a check, important check. Somehow the games were also too intense before, and I burned so much energy, and probably also my heart is, all these time pressures is handling very, very badly. Oops, some mosquito is attacking me. That's not what I need in this sharp Sicilian. And yeah, finally in all these games, just after some, also against Kramnik, this third game was an epic battle. I mean, it was just such a great feeling to play such a fascinating game. With Kramnik, I already felt like I should be winning right from the beginning with black. Step by step, I was building up the position. Kramnik was with white and he gambled. He got some very dangerous counterplay. I mean, that's why he sacrificed the pawn. I mean, Kramnik is known to be very, very reliable. So if he sacrifices something, there is good reason for it. But I managed to handle everything perfectly, and I think finally I avoided all his attacking possibilities, and then time was ticking down and the blunder came. Then I was completely lost, just really completely, because okay, I had like 5 seconds left and he was tricky, very, very tricky. So yeah, then finally he missed the win himself, then he was done on time. But even just talking about that game takes too much energy. So, and the battle is on here, and I'm losing too much time. Sorry, guys. Yeah, Vladimir is tough, even just to talk about that game, because it was, I mean, if you haven't seen it, please check it out. So much dramas. I mean, I think it affected my play in the fourth game, because if we would have had a more sane game, then game four would have never happened the way it happened. And also what I felt like against Kramnik, and also against Svidler, because I had two wide games in the fourth game, and basically at the moment of one and a half standing. So I had a chance to, with wide, just to force a draw and play for Armageddon. And the point is that, okay, I simply feel that the spirit of this Legends of Chess is not about Armageddon. So I just wanted to forget about this and play normal chess. But what to do if you are already not capable of playing normal chess? And by trying to fight, I was I actually thrown away the games, and those games hurt it big time, and I got 0 points. That's what hurt me even more, the 0 points. So I felt like if I will have another chance, I will go for the Armageddon, and first I want to get some point, get some confidence, and then we will see what will happen next. But not to throw any more games in the fourth game. And today it worked out because I managed to win exactly the fourth game. Yes, it was a very unfortunate situation because Vichy actually mouse slipped. But to be fair, he was very unlucky because he fell into some devilish preparation. And I knew how to continue and how to win actually, even if he would have taken my pawn on f5. It's actually very instructive. So I got lucky there to be able to use my preparation in a very critical moment and come back in the match. So I have played with Kramnik student. It was a tough battle, but thanks to this queen h5 check, I feel like I managed to get things under control. So let's see some new opponent. Yes, Speck Cook. This is some Dutch colleague. I mean, playing in Wijkenzee, Tilburg before. I have so many nice memories from Holland Groningen as well. It always felt very nice to be in Holland because also the public respects, appreciates what you are doing. And this is one of the nicest things and most important things, I believe, for a chess player. All this atmosphere in Wijkenzee, and now the Tata Steel Tournament, it's just a pleasure to be there. The last 2 years, I haven't been playing, but I had been there as the trainer of Vincent Keimer, my young German prodigy talent student. I'm already talking nonsense. Don't even listen what I'm talking. But there also I was joining the commentary, and it was so much fun just to comment all those games, because this Vikings is also legendary with 14 players. So a lot of mix, a lot of young faces, many established already world-class players. Always a pure pleasure to be part of Vikenze in every case. So what is this? My opponent goes for the sharpest with 16 hunted. I mean, wow, this is a trick. I feel like my opponent wants to troll me, because this is no way you play the main line of the Catalan with this pawn sacrifice without knowing quite some stuff. Okay, this game is serious. I don't know the time control. Where can I read? This is only written at the start, yeah, that when we pick the game, that what is the time control, because I just don't see it. Okay, let me hang on to my pawn. Okay, my opponent wanted to take the pawn instead of playing e4, because I believe the whole point of this pawn sacrifice is actually to play e4. But now all of a sudden d4 pawn is hanging, and yeah, the knight on b6 is ugly. On the other hand, pawn is a pawn. And also white's play is a little bit restricted. So e3, okay, let's play knight fd5. If we are pawn up, then every change is kind of okay for us. And I also have some hidden idea. There we go. Let's trap this bishop. Let's trap this bishop on f4. This is the danger when you develop the bishop to f4 and then play g3, e3 in the Catalan. Yes, all of a sudden, this bishop can be trapped. And exactly this is what we are witnessing now. Yeah, this is bad luck, because white was doing good, but finally the bishop got trapped. And piece is a piece. Before it was pawn was a pawn, now piece is a piece. And how to fight? I'm gonna go queen b6, queen b4, bothering the queen immediately, just not to give white time to create anything. It's not clear how to create anything anyway, but if I can even avoid giving that chance, then let's do it. But did I? Suddenly some queen h5, bishop e4, I have to get this bishop to e8 quickly. I feel like I was talking too much. Sorry, I mean pawn on e5. I was expecting f4, and I almost kind of pre-moved bishop d7. And that's how the e5 pawn remained alive. Now I'm taking it. I mean, today in today's match against Vichy, in the first game, one of the craziest moves ever made in my chess career happened. When, okay, the point was that I had very, very little time for very long time, and it was very, very messy. I mean, first, I think I had a good position, then Vichy played a brilliant game because he somehow shuffled his pieces, and he, I would not say that he outplayed me, because it was not about outplaying. He simply played so nice. I knew exactly what he will be doing, but I already let him do it, so I had to react. Then I find a lot of great defenses with very little time. Then he was going crazy that he cannot finish me off, and then suddenly it turned, and then finally I'm completely winning, and I felt like, nah, it's winning. And instead of winning the game on the spot, I let him checkmate me in two moves. That was, of course, I mean, I felt my heart got a real hit. My heart got a real hit. So let's see, who do we have? We have so many challenges. Okay, Red Ribbon was here for a long time already. Let's see, one of the first challenges. It's a 5 minutes game. Okay, I will try to play as quickly as possible. But Red Ribbon had been here from the start. But where is he? Was he there from the start, but he disappeared? Maybe he was disappointed that I was not picking him fast enough. Yes. Okay. Yeah, later if it will happen, then we will get back to this game. I mean, really sorry, very highly rated opponents, after all this crazy day what I had. I don't really want to have such a big fight immediately. Okay, don't give up. I might change my mind, but I should have bought. Okay, good. Yeah, thank you. Yes, okay, because I was picking, but I just couldn't. Okay, so I chose VRL. Let's choose VRL. And let's go. VRL, already the name is kind of frightening, because when you play against VRL, then immediately Bologan is coming to mind. Maybe is it Bologan, but hopefully not. It would not be the most unpleasant opponent in Banter Blitz after playing a match already with Vichy. Wow, but VRL is VRL. I'm going for some ultra sharp bishop c4 Nydorf. Oops. This is tricky because I don't play this so often, and it's very dangerous. One has to be careful right from the beginning. And look at this, my opponent jumps on me. I mean, this is a real, very aggressive, very, very aggressive. So what to do now? Queen g4. Okay, I feel like, should I just give the exchange? I mean, what time control do we play? This is another question. I mean, should I just, okay, no, I play g6. Okay, doesn't matter. I wasted way too much time. That's not what I was supposed to do, but okay, it already happened. And I'm pretty sure I mixed up something. I mean, this g6 was not the move. I wanted to castle bishop a6, g6, and just give this exchange for the dark squared bishop, but okay. I already picked this. I have to cook with this, what I got. And what is the time control here? I'm 156. So probably we don't have any increment. Yeah, so it's time to... time to speed up. I wonder when this knight d5 sacrifice will come or it will not come. Because I have some counter check on d3 after this rook d1. But this is way too sharp for my taste for tonight. I mean, I should have played something more technical than this. Okay, h4, h5. Oops, what did I do? Why did I weaken e6 square? I mean, now all these sacrifices are hanging in the air. I did not want to let this happen at all. So what is this? All these sacrifices. Okay, so I go knight b6, very ugly move. Not happy at all playing such moves, but okay, I just want to stop all kinds of sacrifices. I said I wanted to stop all kind of, I mean, I'm going crazy because I let bishop e6 happen. Okay, it's not the end of the world, but the whole plan was not to let any sacrifices happen. I mean, it's crazy. Things are out of control here. Things are out of control. Now my opponent is thinking, looking, searching for the strike, because there are so many options, but it's, to be honest, yeah, bishop e6 is played, but very difficult to evaluate that where does this lead. I mean, if you have computer assistance, then it's very easy to understand, but without computer assistance, it's very tough. And we have already no time. We have already no time. Check. Let's see it. So what do we have? Two pieces. Wow, bishop d6 played instantly. It was a good move. Hang on, this is now tricky. Okay, I have to take, I have to jump. I have to take this pawn. This pawn was disturbing. Let's take another pawn. G4. Ah, wow, it's about flagging, yeah? Completely forgot that this is Armageddon. Oh, okay. You remember I told you, why is it 1-1? So I already lost to Viorel, yeah? I lost to Viorel and we had another, I mean... Ah, Viorel beat me, he flagged me. Oh my God. Yeah, that's why this Viorel, I mean, I didn't know exactly, but now when it's written 1-1, yeah, that was the Berlin stuff when I was enjoying myself and I was completely winning and so on, and then lost on time. And it was my first game here that I lost and it was written somehow... 1-0, no, 0-1, and I was playing with the black pieces, and for a second I even felt like, wow, you know, I did what Magnus did against Firuza. I think there was this crazy match when Magnus was giving checkmate with less than 1 second on the clock and how happy he was. And for some seconds and even for a few seconds, I felt like this is actually what happened in my game. And I was really happy that, wow. And then it turned out that I got flagged. I lost. That was a cruel moment. That was a cruel moment. And wow, Makovic is also playing very fast. I mean, all these bullet experts, yeah? I mean, bullet or blitz, whatever, I mean, without increment. This is very tricky stuff. Okay, typical Nimco. I mean, typical, I mean that, yeah, white has the two bishops, but black has very nice structure, very nice pieces, very harmonious pieces. Actually feels that black is perfectly fine here. But let's see. Let's see what do we get. C4 was slightly irritating because I wanted to get knight b6. I would have enjoyed even more the situation, but all of a sudden things are heating up. Expecting queen d4 and rook fd8. And the queen is a little bit unfortunate on d4. I want to make good use of it with some knight c5 tempo. I mean, white's pieces, bishop on c1, bishop on c4, they are all loose. I have some knight c5, some square on d3. I mean, that's where my horse is heading. So white has to pin with some queen c3. But also I have some knight g4 ideas. I mean, I never know when is this mate. Then is it nothing? Because if it's nothing, then it's premature to go for it. I mean, seems like I'm unable to calculate. So, okay, I will just play natural moves. Let's just play natural moves. What comes to mind? Bishop b1, trying to change. So what do we have? Takes knight e4 tempo. I mean, my knights are quite strong. Knight takes f2. Some small little tactics. I mean, usually that's what happens if you have a superior position. And that was always my motto. You have to wait till the tactic comes to you, not you should run after the tactic, because then you lose objectivity. Those were the words of one of my young trainers. And I liked it. Oops, I'm taking the rook. Yeah, the knight was just too strong. Was disturbing too much. So I'm expecting queen g4, yeah? It's why not to try checkmate? I already blundered one checkmate today. Maybe I will blunder another one. It's a fair guess, but I mean, somehow I feel like it was enough what I've done today. And blundering one checkmate was not enough. So let's change this rook. Eliminating the possibilities, the options of blundering some more material. And now everything is under control. Yeah. And white resigned. Okay. Mr. Makovic. So what do we have? I mean, I would be happy to get the 2 seconds increment, because then I would not be... Okay, knight of master here, 3+2. That's because I feel like in 3+2 we have more time to talk. After all, Banter Blitz is not about result. It's about having some fun. I would like to say some things about the game, but when it's bang, 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 bang. But I chose Knight of Master, giving him even the chance with e4 to play the knight. And there we go. Okay. There we go. There we go. But sorry, mister. No knight off. I mean, have mercy on my heart. I want to play something more simple, more strategic. All these chess 24 ratings are very, very confusing because you never know when they are right, when they are not. To be honest, I also created some anonymous account just to play a few games, and all of a sudden I started with 1500. And I started beating some players, and probably my play was quite convincing, even so convincing that my opponents believe that I'm cheating for sure. And they started cheating against me. I mean, that was just incredible. I mean, all these players with 1800 were just playing like level 3000 a tempo every move. I mean, it was like a shock. Shock to me that what can happen, and then I just stopped because I cannot. It was not the purpose of playing with anonymous account, few games just to get some feeling, and then all of a sudden facing super engines without even knowing which engine exactly. Yeah, so I'm getting some experience. Yeah. Getting some online experience. And here also, I mean, black is doing everything right. I mean, with 1659, I mean, I'm pretty sure that my opponent's rating is at least 2200. I'm pretty sure. I mean, this is quite decent, only he's playing a little bit slow. I mean, that's the problem. And what was the time control here? I don't know. Okay, I will see if black gets extra seconds or not. So 139, 139, I'm very curious. Yeah, but I missed that moment. I have no clue if we have increment or not. I'm probably just too tired already. I cannot follow all this, cannot watch the clock, look at the position, talk. But it's a Marozzi structure. That I still understand. Let's put the pieces where they belong. Bishop e3. Okay, king should also go to h1. So not, wow, queen a5 blitzed out a tempo. Okay, queen d2. That's also typical stuff. King. The queen went back all the way to d8. Feels like black is not completely sure what to do. So let's increase the iron grip. It's a Marozzi structure. No. I don't want to change pieces. No. that's not what white is, or the side with the space advantage should do. I mean, I want to keep as many pieces as possible, then black feels all the more uncomfortable. Okay, now it gets to f4. Maybe it gets to d5. Shuffling the pieces back and forth, improving the position, and waiting for the right moment to strike somewhere. I mean, I was saying that I don't want to change pieces, but if I get jump with the knight to d5, then I'm ready to change, because this knight on d5 is just a monster. Eyeing the b6 square, it's a fork, pawn on g5 is hanging. I mean, black's position seems to collapse. Black goes berserk with g4. I mean, black wants to create some threats, but where are the threats? Seems like I have things under control. Now I have a nice choice. Take with pawn, take with queen. Okay, let's take with queen. Let's stick to solid approach, yeah? As Already we said enough adventure was seen and felt today. Let's play simple. Okay. Let's take CD. Basically, but I let black get the blockade. Okay, I mean, the blockade doesn't really bring much, but I should have not let this happen. Okay, I'm bringing my king to E2 as well. E6, okay, let's go B4. Let's take with this rook. Black's clock is running out. Rook takes B6. The blockade is broken. So how to finish it off? Okay, let's go to B5. Let's go to B5, let's take, let's eliminate everything. Simple chess, continue taking everything. And I'm expecting resignation, exactly. So Neidorf master, sorry, I didn't let you play Neidorf. I know it was not fair, but I mean, I had to keep my professional attitude. And I got a really nice position. So what do we have? There are so many challenges, Okay, let's go for this one. I mean, I'm very bad with French pronunciation, so I don't dare to pronounce it, but here we go, we have a battle. Ragozin, which turned to be a Nimco. It's a Nimco again. We have seen something similar. If black white would play a3, then takes Qc7 would be the same. After castles, we are seeing the famous Karpov system. It's the name after knight takes d4. After e takes d4, b6 is known to be the famous Karpov system. And okay, let me destroy the structure. Yeah, I give the bishop. I'm not proud of it, but okay, I just want to play structure. Knight bd7. So I have to watch out not to blunder some bishop takes e6, cheapo. Because after, before bishop a3, bishop takes e6 was answered by knight c5, but if I would have moved my rook to d8, then all of a sudden bishop takes e6 would have won on the spot. So yeah, I mean, this is not a complex position. I mean, black should be perfectly fine, but I actually would like to get more than just fine position. If I get my bishop to e6, then it will all make perfect sense. And I got it. Bishop to e6. Then let's go knight e4. Let's just jump with the knight. Changing the bishop, yeah, it's kind of double-edged. It makes a lot of sense, but it was by no way obligatory. But I see this pawn on c3. I see some weak pawn on a4. My knight on e4 is just very, very strong. Queen on c4 is brutally strong. Yeah, so my opponent goes for this, but now can I take the pawn? At least I will. I hope I can. Because d1 is hanging, so there is no queen takes b7 trick because d1 is hanging. Yeah, this, and I want it to come back. Because there is still this queen d1 checkmate after taking on b7. And yeah, that was kind of the idea that, okay, now I'm pawn up and I consolidate. My only problem is if I play b5, then knight b4, all of a sudden my queen is trapped there on a4. I don't want this. So queen c4. Yeah, white lost the pawn, but at least one can claim that he got rid of his weakness on a4. He got rid of this weakness on a4, so I'm playing rook c8. I see another weakness still on c3. Oops, now this will cost material, excuse me. A5. This will lose material. Now I'm collecting the rook. I'm collecting everything. Yeah. Okay, thank you. What do we have? What do we have next? So little Gary, let's see who is this Mr. Little Gary. Sven, you already hear Gary, you feel like Gary is around. Gary Kasparov, Gary the boss. I mean, playing all those games with Kasparov, it was such a pleasure. I mean, just incredibly great player. It was always such a privilege to play with him. And I think at some point I got quite a good feeling for those games, and we had insanely intense battles in Linares. I mean, whenever I think about the tournament Linares, the Wimbledon of chess, I somehow immediately remember all those clashes with Kasparov, because there were so many epic battles there with him. It's really sad that Linares stopped, because that was one of a kind tournament. It was always considered like the unofficial world championship. Okay, knight d6. Yeah, I'm not blundering anything. So takes. I'm pawn up, healthy pawn up. Have the dark square bishops, two bishops. All the reasons to be happy, and even to be very happy. Developing with the pieces. Just developing. Bishop to c4. It kind of breaks my heart. I wanted to say that if black goes queen e7, I don't want to change the queens, but I mean, I would have just castled and okay, but this is looking like it should end. This battle should end soon. Because I'm breaking through. What is this? I can take everything, yeah? Just everything, free choice. I even don't know what to take. Okay. I will play primitive. Just take this. Knight. One knight is enough. And I still have the pair of bishops. Yeah. Thank you, little Gary. That was kind of quick. Black's active play in the king's in the center backfired. So let's get some master. Let's check who is this master, some mysterious master. I hope that I didn't pick the wrong one, because don't mess with the master. Let's check, what is it? Another names or no? Knight f3. Okay, let's play some Queen's Indian. My old beloved Queen's Indian. Okay, let's make it an imzo out of this. This is some really sharp old theoretical line. This is how the old maestros were playing. Takes on c3, get the e4 square. Oops, this we run into queen h4 check. Oy, 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 oy. That was because the idea knight d2 fc is correct, but once first white has to castle short, and only then can he play like this. So what is this? I mean, king e2 is obligatory. And it's even kind of feeling sad to just pick up the exchange with knight g3. Actually, I don't want, but okay, like this, then I take the full look. Thank you very much. This is as bad as my position yesterday against Kramnik in the fourth game. I mean, I went completely crazy. I mean, this is when I feel the mental exhaustion comes. I have seen bishop takes h3 sacrifice. Of course, I have seen it. But probably if it's over the board, I evaluate it correctly, but simply I was just too tired, and I see that bishop takes h3 does not lead to perpetual check because my king runs away, so no problem. I go knight b6, Kramnik takes bishop h3. Of course, there is no perpetual check because black is not giving perpetual check. He just mates me or queen his h pawn. I mean, this was some incredible hallucination. I mean, just connected to the previous game. That's the only thing I can explain, especially because instead of knight b6, I could have played king g1 when I feared that he might repeat the moves with queen g5. I mean, okay, why to get mated instead of avoiding some possible repetition? And I'm even not sure if Kramnik would have repeated because he was in a very, very aggressive mood anyway, so it would have given me also chances. Okay, let's take this Andre. I mean, that moment when I realized that, oops, yeah, I mean, of course he doesn't have a perpetual check because this is mate. I mean, that was mate or the pawn queens. I mean, I felt like if we are not playing for public, if I'm at home, I would just sew the pieces together and say that, okay, sorry, my friend, next game. I mean, it was some terrible blunder, but we are playing for the audience. I felt like, okay, it is my duty to let myself be checkmated so that the people also see where does it lead, actually. I mean, it was a very sad, really sad part of playing that game because I already knew immediately after bishop takes h3 that, yeah, man, I mean, what have you done? And that's why real pity, because we played some really very interesting games, and this last game could have been also a very good game, a very big fight, but I just thrown it like this, and that's not only losing a game, but another sleepless night, because how can you forget such thing? You just cannot. At least I'm not good at this, forgetting things. I mean, I remember very well how stupid I was. And you are just twisting, turning, then you look at the clock, it's 5 a.m., it's 7 a.m., then suddenly the neighbor starts to be active. I mean, it's a nightmare. And then you just wait for the alarm and that's it. Yeah, this is the point why probably playing the Nidorf is not a bad idea. Because when you play the Nidorf, then you get much sharper game, but I mean, here also, this game is another example that, yeah, it was simple, but even in simple position, it's easy to make mistake. White was fighting for the d-file, but forgot the pawn on a2. So I gained some pawn. And pawn is a pawn. This we have already discussed. So what does black have in store? White. Okay, B4, queen C2, just to tease a little bit. I mean, when do you get a black queen on C2? It's not very often. Actually, I'm very happy with all this online business because finally I got a good mouse, I got a good chair, I feel like I'm ready to play chess. I haven't been active for a very long time. I even had my doubts that, okay, what are my practical skills, especially in online chess? But so far the tournament shows that, I don't have to be afraid. I can still play chess. And that's a good feeling. The only thing, I'm not sure how good it is for my health, because probably if you are used to all these battles, then you handle it much more easy. But like this, that I have been inactive for so long, every game that I play makes me so exciting, because I'm playing a game and when things turn that some terrible time pressure ends badly, then it's so difficult for me to adjust to the next game. Like if nothing happened, this is what I feel during the tournament, that whenever I had this crazy game, then 10 minutes and we already continue. And in these 10 minutes, I'm not able to recover emotionally. I still feel like my heart is still very much involved of bumping. Just it's not easy. And once you are not able to calm down, then some disaster is guaranteed to happen. And I know this, but what can I do? I mean, basically the medicine is probably just to play much more. I mean, if one plays and he gets used to all these ups and downs also, then it's easier to handle. But for me, after more than 10 years without any online, and not just online, when I played this Banter Blitz session, those were the first games of the season for me. It was a very special moment. I even read some comments on YouTube. Yeah, they were saying, yeah, I'm very rusty. I already a little bit forgot to play. I was missing not taking some pieces or whatever. But believe me, I mean, this whole Banter Blitz is, I don't care about the result. It's not about the result. It's about having fun. It's a very nice format. And it's also a nice way to communicate with the fans, because I'm not having any social media account. So it's not like after the game I'm tweeting something or I can say something. And that's why I also like to join the live commentary after the games. Even if you are exhausted, I still feel like it's kind of nice to get rid of the emotions, because if you lost, then you want to say why you lost and you want to give all these negative emotions out, and also to show to the public what you have seen and how intense the games were. Of course, if they were intense, luckily so far in the tournament, the games are quite intense. And then it's kind of also a very nice way of communicating. But okay. And when you win, then of course, exactly for that reason that, okay, you are happy, then also it's nice to explain. Whoops, but I'm talking too much, and this is what is it? I mean, I looked at the rating of my opponent and saw that this will be some easy rider. And my opponent is playing very solid. So let's concentrate, and probably we have again no increment. I have to concentrate. I also had no time to change the clothes. So sorry that I'm in the same clothes like in the tournament, but I felt like, okay, now I just don't have the time already to change and to decide what to wear, what not to wear. I stick to the same outfit. So it's like an official outfit now. And that's, thanks to this outfit, I also feel like I'm almost like I'm playing a tournament, because it's my usual attire when playing chess. So what do we have? My opponent is ahead on the clock. Few seconds ahead on the clock. We are about to simplify the position. Yeah, simplifications are always two-sided, because if it simplifies for nothing, then it's kind of nothing. But often, if you get something, then even something is more than enough in a simplified position, because there are not so many pieces. Every small nuance counts. And now here we go. We have some endgame. Okay, so takes. Giving a check. And I'm going rook d2. And I'm hitting white pawns. And collecting. I'm collecting. I'm Mr. Collector. Okay, takes. Bring the king. All the rules of the endgame. And I will just march with my king to the other side. Collect another pawn and finish the game. And there will be no flagging. I mean, now it's... Now I'm already also master of pre-moving, especially if it's an extra pawn which runs to queen. Okay, this king is coming closer to some mating net. Still running. Look at this, queen takes f3, stalemate. Unbelievable. I mean, this is chess. I mean, you would continue and you just pick up the piece and all of a sudden it's a draw. No, this is not checkmate, but what a trick, what a troll, Mr. One Dragon. Amazing. If I would have talked here and collected the knight and then say, oops, it's stalemate, that would have been just an incredible feeling. John Emmanuel offered a 3+2 game. Let's take this 3+2. So no flagging, fair play. Let's see how this game will continue. D4, another D4. So many D4s. So today only D4 and E4 challenges. I haven't got any C4. I haven't got any knight F3s. I know there was one C4. Of course, I even said that my opponent tried to play like Kramnik did against me. So yeah, okay. This is the so-called London system. A very, very solid system. It used to be the lazy system, and nobody was really taking it seriously because lazy players were playing it with lazy ideas. And then all of a sudden, what happened? Vladimir Kramnik picked it up and played some training games with Magnus. And then all of a sudden, Magnus was also picking up. To be fair, Gatakamski was a great expert of the London system, but he kind of more or less played the old conservative classical way. And the new impulse was brought by Kramnik and Magnus, but Kamsky, of course, remains one of the leading experts. It fits his style also very, very much. And I remember that in some rapid blitz games, I was suffering a lot against Gata. He was just very, very solid with his stuff and plays very quickly. And this is exactly what you need in a blitz game. Yeah, you know all the plans. You just play instantly, putting the pressure on the clock. And I had some difficult moments against Gata in one of these, what was it, sport accord events in China, in Beijing. I was suffering big time. But for all this punishment that Gata was giving me in the blitz and rapid games, I have a very good score against him in the classical chess. So it's a kind of very interesting psychological situation that that I'm doing very well against him in classical, and he's doing very well against me in rapid blitz. I always wonder why is this that, you know, two super grandmasters playing each other. I mean, there is just absolutely no reason why those designs should happen like they are happening. But somehow there is a tendency that when it started, then it continues. You know, it's very, very interesting. Chess is a very psychological game. I don't know, maybe you overthink the situation against this opponent and you want to be ultra precise. And when you try to be ultra precise, usually finally something always happens. The best way is just to play your chess. And that's the best way. Meanwhile, I'm getting outplayed, just like by Gatakamski. So yeah, look at my knight on c7, knight on g7. I mean, two terrible knights. So I have to do something with these knights. Okay, one guy is at least on its way to b4 or to b8. So I was even not interested to go rook c2. I just first wanted to get my knight out because I want to feel a little bit better. Okay, so wow, what a blunder. You see, that's why the knight rerouted itself, hitting on d4, and my opponent collapsed immediately because he felt like I'm also doing something. This is often the case when you feel like you are controlling everything, you don't want to give your opponent any chance, and then he suddenly gets out, then it's very easy to blunder, because trying to control everything, it's based on too many aspects, and you are focused on too many, and then you miss some very simple stuff. And then people don't understand how could he miss, and you also don't understand how could I miss. But actually, it's just the logical follow-up of the situation. I know this very well because it happened to me many times, especially with very little short on time. I'm always trying to control everything, and when suddenly things get out of control and you have no time, it's basically game over, because it's almost guaranteed that you will collapse. At least, unfortunately, it's happening to me way too often. All right, so let's play against Mr. Onam, Mariano Aviol Perez. It's 3+2. Let's play this game. I'm going e4. This is like now one of the last games. Really sorry, guys. Now I'm just way too tired. I just don't want to think anymore. I believe there will be a next Banter Blitz as well, coming back somewhere when I will have time, and it's such a great pleasure to do it. I'm happy that you guys also like. Please share your views, because it's really appreciated if you share on YouTube your views, how you think about it, what you thought about the session, because since I'm nowhere else to find, I'm actually reading. It's very interesting, and also for me very nice to get some feedback, to know how people are enjoying or not enjoying the show. It also helps me to improve. Wow, look at this, one of the last games, and always something happens. Yeah, and just as I explained, if you try to control things, things get out of control. And here we go, some really sharp position, really sharp pierce. My opponent basically is not even hiding his intentions. That, let me checkmate Peter. I mean, after all, he's talking too much. I got the message. But I don't know. I mean, I rely on my knight on c1. After all, they say the knight is the best friend of the king. let's see if that's true, because I really rely that this knight will just do the job against the bishop on e6, knight on b6, queen a5, and rook b8. Those are four pieces, yeah? Four real pieces. I mean, it's not to be underestimated. So I'm coming with knight g5. At least I would like to create some threats myself. We might exchange this bishop, but for my knight. But if I get a pawn to b3, I feel like my king is much, much safer. So my opponent is not interested on taking, but okay, is there some threat? No, okay, then let's go. If there is no threat, then let's go. h4, h5. Let's create some contention. I mean, there were all kinds of queen g7, bishop takes e4, e5, but I'm already too tired to let this knight come and maybe do something to me, even if I didn't see what exactly black could do. And yes, and if I push e5, then actually this knight could jump and there were all kind of double piece sacrifices. So I'm planning to open up. But again, look at this. My opponent has 1,386 rating and plays so well. It just cannot be. I mean, this also some player who just started out and he has a low rating, or I don't know. I mean, this is, everybody's getting so strong. This chess24 helps so much. Yeah, everywhere chess, everywhere lessons, everywhere information. Everybody's improving. Incredible. So now it feels like there are much less pieces that attack my king. And look at my pieces. Look on e1, look on d1, targeting the king on e8. I mean, just one little move, e4, e5, and I'm opening up the center, but I mean, I'm not sure that I want to do that so quickly, because then again, some knight d5, knight c3 jumps are coming, but now I think I'm gonna do it. I mean, it cannot, e5, knight d5, e d6, knight a3 check, I'm even not forced to take, knight c3 check, I'm forced to take, then queen a3, but rook e7, queen f8, checkmate. Okay, so it's a very principled way of dealing with the situation. It's move per move stuff. But if black takes on e5, I take d5, I get control of the d5 square. And after knight d5, I just want to take on d6, and then rook e7, queen f8 will be checkmate. That's the idea. So we are going towards this variation. There is also some nice motif that if black, for example, plays rook b7 just to protect the e7, of course, I have many options, but I have d takes c5, knight c3 check, b takes c3, queen a3, threatening checkmate, and suddenly c takes b4, and the queen from g7 defends back on b2. I mean, that I felt just way too beautiful not to mention. Okay, now knight e6 or rook e6. I mean, okay, rook e6. Is begging to be played. And finally, this knight, which was defending, does the final check and taking the queen. And that should be it. That should be it, yeah. And black resigned. I mean, what a game. What a game. At the end, my opponent was very, very aggressive. Very, very aggressive, but I managed to fight back. And I was the first to get to my opponent's king. I mean, thank you very much for the challenges for this Banter Blitz. I know it's still like 2 more minutes, but please forgive me of not starting another game. Tomorrow, a big match against Jan Nepomniachtchi is coming up. I had already a very tough day today. Was very happy with all the how it ended today. It's a great feeling of beating the incredible legend Vishyanand. In fact, I think it was the first ever match victory against Vishyanand for me. We had some incredible battles, tie breaks, decisive tie breaks, and so on. But he always came up somehow victorious after incredible dramas. Also, sometimes he managed to beat me smoother as well. But yeah, today was suddenly now my turn, winning in Armageddon. I mean, of course, it was an epic battle. Vishy would have deserved to win that match as well, just as I did. So thank you very much. And looking forward to play lot of more great games in this Legends of Chess. It's a wonderful event. It's so nice to be part of it. It's a big honor and a big privilege to play this event with all these fantastic players. So thank you very much.